Hey friends, today I'll be sharing this cute textured bralette, or you can also call it a crop top if you like, just in time for a bikini season. And if you're new to my channel and want in on all the latest patterns, go ahead and click that subscribe button now. For this pattern, I'm using Cascade Fixation yarns in three colors, white, light blue, and dark blue, and you can find the link to these yarns in the description box below. I'm also using a 2.25mm crochet hook. You'll also need a tapestry needle, a measuring tape, and some stitch markers. We'll first be working on the cups, working my way from the inside out. I'm starting with the white yarn and chaining 24 plus 1 chains. This starting chain is for all sizes, but for this tutorial, I'll be making a C cup. Once you've completed the chains, we will be working half double crochet stitches. So we'll yarn over, insert your hook through the second chain from the hook, drop a loop, yarn over, and pull through all loops. We'll continue to work a total of 24 half double crochet stitches along this row all the way across. Once you've reached that last stitch, we'll want to switch yarn colors. So before closing that last stitch, we'll take our light blue yarn and pull it through that last stitch. You do not need to bind off the white yarn. Chain one, and this is how your first row should look like. We'll turn our work, and on that first stitch, carry along that excess tail and work a half double crochet stitch. Continue to work half double crochet stitches along this row, and I'll meet you back here to turn. Once you've reached that last stitch, we'll turn our work to the side and insert a hook through that last post and work 5 half double crochet stitches. Next, we'll turn to the chain side and insert your hook through that first chain and work a half double crochet and across. Make sure you have a total of 24 half double crochet stitches on this side. If you hate weaving in ends as much as I do, here's a little trick you can do. Before reaching the end of the row, pick up the excess tail we made earlier at the beginning of the chain and bring it forward like this and work your stitches around it. And once you're done stitching around it, just pull that excess tail slightly and snip it off. Voila! No weaving in ends. Now that we've completed the second row, on that last stitch, we'll pick up our dark blue yarn and pull it through all three loops. Without binding off the light blue yarn, chain one and turn your work. On our third row, we'll be working somewhat of an alpine stitch. So work a double crochet stitch on that first stitch while carrying along the excess tail. On the second stitch, we'll work a front post double crochet stitch. So insert your hook behind the next post and work a double crochet stitch, like so. Find your third stitch and work a regular double crochet stitch. Repeat this front post double crochet stitch and regular double crochet stitch all the way across until you've reached the 5 half double crochet shell stitch, and I'll meet you back once we're there. Once you've reached that first shell stitch, work 2 double crochet stitches on that stitch. Next, work 1 double crochet stitch, followed by 5 double crochet stitches on that next stitch. Now we'll repeat exactly what we did on the other side. So we'll work one double crochet followed by two double crochet stitches. This is how it should look like on the wrong side. And this is how it should look like on the right side. Next, we'll work a front post double crochet stitch. Followed by a regular double crochet stitch. And we'll repeat this pattern all the way across. On that last stitch, only draw up through two loops, and on that last loop, we'll pick up the white yarn and pull through two loops to close the stitch. Make sure that your tension is loose, just like this. Chain one and turn your work. And continue to half double crochet each stitch across all the way until you've reached the first stitch of the shell stitch at the top. Once you've reached the first stitch of the shell stitch, work two half double crochets on that stitch, followed by one half double crochet. Next, work your shell stitch or five half double crochet stitch on that next stitch. And then now we'll just work a mirror image. So work one half double crochet, followed by two half double crochet on the next stitch. And then continue to work one half double crochet on each stitch across. On your last stitch, pick up the light blue yarn and pull through the last stitch to close. Make sure your tension is loose. Chain one, turn your work, and on this row, work regular half double crochet stitches all the way across and increase at the top just like how you did on the previous row. And I'll meet you back here once that's done. I've just completed this row, and now on my last stitch, I'll be picking up my dark blue yarn, pulling through that last stitch, and chain one, making sure that my tension is loose. Turn your work around, and on that first stitch, work one double crochet. Now on this row, we'll be working the opposite of what we did on the previous dark blue row. So here now, I'm facing the right side. So instead of working a front post double crochet, we'll now be working a back post double crochet. So insert my hook from the back through the front of the next post, like so. I'll drop a loop, pull through two, pull through two. So that's how you do a back post double crochet. Next, find your third stitch and work a regular double crochet. Followed by another back post double crochet. Continue this pattern across until you've reached the first stitch of the shell stitch and increase like how you did on the previous rows. Then go ahead and repeat the last five rows until you've reached your preferred cup size. I'm now working on my last row, which is also my 12th row, and I will stop at the top to work on the ties. Once I've reached the middle of the shell stitch, I'll insert my hook, hold onto the tip, and with my left hand, I'll pull the yarn as long as two arms' length four times. Next, with my right hand, I'll take both yarns and I'll pull the yarn with my left hand all the way across. This will give me a thicker strand to work on the ties. Next, from your last stitch, draw the double yarn. You can see the double yarn here. And work a double crochet stitch or a half double crochet stitch if you're on another row. Now, I'll be working chains. Continue to chain up all the way until the end. This is how your tie should look like. Now to finish off this last row, insert your hook through the top of that last stitch that you made. Pick up your working yarn and pull through a loop. From here, continue working your stitch, whether it's a double crochet or a half double crochet stitch, all the way across. So this is how your finished cup should look like. This is the wrong side, which is also really pretty, but I chose this to be my right side because I really like how the texture worked out. Now go ahead and work a second cup by repeating the exact same pattern as you did earlier. Now we'll be connecting both cups together. On the last stitch of the second cup, chain 5. Then slip stitch onto the first stitch of the first cup, making sure that it's facing the same side as your second cup. Chain 1 and bind off. Now turn your work upside down. Facing the right side, we'll work chains all the way until the middle of each cup. So insert your hook at the outer corner of the cup. I'm using the dark blue yarn because that is the last yarn color that I use for the cups and ties. To determine the number of chains you need, count the number of rows on half a cup. So work one chain for every half double crochet row and two chains for every double crochet row. For cup C, I've made a total of 16 chains. Pull your chain over across the cup and make sure that it reaches the middle of the cup. Otherwise, just increase or reduce the number of chains until it does. Now go ahead and do the same thing on the other side. On your last chain, work one more chain to start the next row. And because I'm using the dark blue yarn, I'll be working double crochet stitches. So continue to work double crochet or half double crochet stitches on each chain across. Once you've reached the underside of the cup, work 2 stitches on each double crochet row and 1 stitch on each half double crochet row. Do this all the way across while working around the loose joining yarns. Once you've reached the middle joining chain, go ahead and work 1 stitch on each chain. Then proceed to work all the way across the next cup. So this is how the first row should look like. Chain 1 and turn your work. On the second row, we'll be working on the alpine stitches. So work your double crochet stitch on the first stitch, followed by a front post double crochet stitch. Find your third stitch and work that double crochet stitch and repeat this pattern all the way across. On the last stitch, pick up the next color, in my case it would be white, and pull through the last stitch to close. Chain 1 and turn. No need to bind off. On this row, I'll be working single crochet stitches across. So insert your hook through that first stitch while carrying along the excess tail and work that single crochet. continue to single crochet each stitch, and I'll meet you back here once we're done. On that last stitch, chain one and turn your work. Now, just like before, we'll work the alpine stitch. On that first stitch, we'll work a double crochet stitch. And because the next stitch is a protruding stitch, we'll just work a regular double crochet on the next stitch. The third stitch is an inverted stitch, so we'll work a front post double crochet on this third stitch. Insert your hook behind the post and work a double crochet. And repeat this pattern all the way across. So I've just completed my second row. Now continue to add as many rows as you like by repeating the same pattern as we did earlier and changing colors on every row. For reference, I have made a total of 6 alpine rows. Once you've completed all your rows, it may curl slightly, and that's okay because now we'll start working on the sides. So turn your work to the side, facing the right side. I will be making 3 loops on my band, but depending on the number of rows you've made, go ahead and make as many numbers of loops as you like. I'll insert my hook through that first stitch, and I'll be using the light blue yarn for the sides because this is the last yarn color that I used. Work 2 single crochets on each double crochet row and 1 single crochet on each single crochet row. Do this all the way across. Once you've completed your first row, chain 1 and turn your work. So as I mentioned earlier, I'll be making 3 tie loops on the side, which means I'll need to divide my total rows into 3 to mark my spot. So here I've made 1 single crochet followed by 3 chains. I'm skipping the next stitch and working 4 single crochet stitches. So here I'm at the middle of my band. I'll chain 3 to make my second loop, skip 1, and work another 4 single crochet stitches. Chain 3, skip 1, and work my last single crochet stitch. You can make more loops if you like by dividing the number of loops with the total number of rows that you made. Bind off and repeat on the other side. And this is how your finished bralette should look like. So we'll turn our work facing the wrong side and fold our band inwards. Now let's weave in the ties. I'm taking the left tie and drawing it through the right band on the first loop and into the second loop on the left band, and the last loop on the right band. And I'll repeat the same process on the other tie. And once you're done, just tie a cute knot and you're ready to wear your Mykonos bralette crop top. I hope you had fun making this with me. And by the way, did you see that it also comes with a matching bottom too? Give me a thumbs up if you like this video and subscribe if you'd like to see more. Have an awesome day!